What are you thinking about, love?
This and that.
I know what you're thinking about. I bet you're thinking about walking with me down the aisle in your best arch supports, with Connie Watkinson looking livid because I've beaten her to it.
No, I'm thinking what a smashing day it is for some good healthy exercise. We should be tramping the moors a day like this. Sun shining, cloudless skies, soft breezes, a couple of pigeons billing and cooing.
You never bill and coo with me, Carter. Why can't we be like them pigeons?
We can if you don't mind climbing to the top of Mr. Warrender's washhouse roof.
Honestly, Carter, there's not a scrap of romance in you. Me? I'm just bursting at the seams with it. You know what I'm thinking about now?
No, what?
Unsworth's pork pies.
What?
I've entered the Sweethearts and Springtime competition, sponsored by Unsworth's pork pies. You've got to pick out the 5 most desirable qualities in the typical family butcher. You know what I've chosen as top?
No.
A highly infectious laugh.
Well, that's not the only highly infectious thing about Unsworth's pork pies, is it?
Oh, it's a marvellous first prize, Carter. Much better than the one for Chatterton's currant loaf. It's a weekend for 2 in Cleethorpes, with candlelight provided, plus as many Unsworth's pork pies as you can eat in the next annual year. If that isn't romantic, I don't know what is.
Neither do I.
Tell me something, Carter. Which do you think's most romantic, candles or nightlights? Well, don't stand there shrugging your shoulders, looking like some other cat dragged in. What's the matter with you?
I'm just wondering what the first prize is for Chatterton's currant loaf.
Good. I'm glad to see you taking an interest. You can help me think up a winning slogan. Do you want to know the one I made up this morning while I was cleaning the bath? I had this sudden flash of inspiration just as I got to the cold tap. I usually do.
Go on, tell us your slogan.
Large or small, big or tall, with Unsworth's pork pies, you'll have a ball. How's that for poetry, Carter?
Perfection.
It's got real rhymes in it, too. It's nearly as good as them that cheerful Charlie Chester reads on the radio in the morning when the Hoover's on and you can't hear the words proper.
Right. Much better than the one I've just thought up.
Oh, what's that, love?
Large or small, big or tall, Unsworth's pork pies will make your shoulders droop.
There you are, not a scrap of romance in you. Me? Oh, I get all romantic just thinking about your mum and dad making all them arrangements for the second honeymoon. Mm. When we've been married 25 years, will you want to go on a second honeymoon with me?
It depends on what the first one was like.
Do you sometimes think we're a couple of funniosities, Carter?
How do you mean?
Well, going to our nuptial bed without having first, well, you know. I mean, you didn't buy your car without having a trial run first, did you?
No.
Well, I'm like your car in that respect.
I hope not. When I had my trial run, we'd only be going half a minute when the 2 front headlights fell off.
Do you ever wonder what it'll be like on the first night of our honeymoon? I do. I've got it all planned out. There'll be mandolins playing in the soft Spanish moonlight. And we won't have eaten no garlic, because we'll choose an hotel that does real food with chips and a choice of veg. Now, do you want a choice of veg, Carter? Or do you prefer a tossed green salad?
No, I'd prefer the garlic. It'll take away the taste of all that lousy ale I've been supping.
You'll not be drinking beer, Carter. You'll be sitting on the balcony of our bedroom drinking champagne with real, genuine bubbles. And then, when we've drunk our Horlicks and taken our iron tablets, you can go into the bathroom and clean your teeth while I slip into my wet-look negligee. And then, when I've got it on, you can come out of the bathroom and I'll watch you change into your midnight blue pyjamas if you promise to turn your back on me at the crucial moment.
Oh, aye. I'll bring some of my mates with me and they can stand round me like they do in the rugby league.
There's no need to be sarky. Oh, Carter, I can hardly wait till we get married. I just can't sleep thinking about it. Hour after hour after hour, I'm tossing and turning and... Oh, I hope it doesn't last.
Why?
Well, don't want to spend all my honeymoon suffering from night starvation, do I?
Kissing. You know you can catch germs kissing at this time of the year. Come to that, you're at grave risk most times of the year. By rights, you should wear a smog mask.
What do you want?
You two, in the front parlour, now. They're just in the process of arriving.
Who?
The three great aunts from Glossop. And God have mercy on our souls.